Hi students, welcome back to my class. We are discussing lines and angles. In a previous section, we discussed exercise 0.3 up to third question. And in today's section, I am going to discuss the fourth question. So what is that one? Fourth one. In a given figure, if the line PQ and RS intersect at the point T. PQ and RS intersect at the point T. Such that angle PRT is 40. PRT is 40 degree, and another one angle they given RPT 95. RPT, this angle is 95, and TSQ is 75. TSQ, it is 75, and we find the angle SQR. So we want to find out this angle how much, right? So let me solve here. First write down what they given. The angle PRT is equal to 40 degree, angle RPT is equal to 95 degree, and angle TSQ is equal to 75 degree. So consider a triangle PRT. In a triangle PRT, so apply angle sum property of a triangle. Means the sum of all three angles is equal to 180. So angle PRT plus angle RPT plus angle PTR is equal to 180 degree. Angle sum property of a triangle, right? So angle PRT they given how much? 40 degree plus angle RPT they given 95 degree plus angle PTR we don't know, keep as it is, so 180 as it is. So make this addition, we got 135 degree plus angle PTR is equal to 180 degree. So 135 comes in RHS and it become a minus. So angle PTR as it is, this is equal to 180 minus 135. So angle PTR is equal to, make this minus, 180 minus 135, we got 45, right? 45. So this angle is 45 degree. And see here, angle PTR is equal to angle STQ, vertically opposite angles, because these two lines are intersect at the T, right? So now angle PTR is equal to angle STQ, vertically opposite angles. So angle STQ is equal to 45 degree, because angle PTR is equal to 45 degree, right? So we got this angle is also 45. So now in a triangle, which triangle? STQ. In a triangle STQ, so apply here angle sum property. So now angle STQ plus angle TSQ plus angle SQT is equal to 180 degree. So here we know that angle STQ is a 45 degree plus 75 degree plus angle SQT. We want to find out SQT, right? SQT as it is equal to 180 degree. So now make this sum, we got here 120 plus SQT is equal to 180 degree. So 120 comes in RHS side, it becomes minus. Angle SQT is equal to 180 minus 120. So angle SQT is equal to, make this minus, we got 60 degree. So this angle is 60 degree. The next question, fifth one. In a given figure, if PQ are perpendicular to PS, PQ is a perpendicular to PS. These two are the perpendicular each other. It means here is a 90 degree, right? And PQ is a parallel to SR. PQ is a parallel to SR. So this line is a parallel. These two are the parallel. So angle SQR is a 28. SQR is a 28. This angle is a 28. And QRT is a 65. QRT. So this angle is a 65. So find the value of X and Y. So here we want to find out the value of X and Y. So let me solve here. First write down what they given here. PQ is a parallel to SR. So PQ is a parallel to SR. So SR, it means QR become a transversal line. So here QR is a transversal. Transversal line. So QR is a transverse line, means in here PQR is equal to angle QRT. So that is angle PQR is equal to angle QRT. Alternate interior angles, right? So angle PQR means the sum of these two, X plus 28. So write down X plus 28 degree is equal to angle QRT, they given 65 degree. So 28 comes in RHS and it become a minus. So X is equal to 65 degree minus 28 degree. So X is equal to, so make this minus, we got 37 degree. So X value is a 37. So this one is 37 degree. Is it clear? So now see here, in a triangle SPQ, X is a 30 degree. This angle is a 37 degree and here is a 90 degree perpendicular to each other. Then we will find out Y value, right? So now in a triangle SPQ, the angle SPQ plus angle PQS plus angle PSQ is equal to 180 degree. Angle sum property of a triangle. So SPQ is a 90 degree because they only say perpendicular to each other, right? And plus, already we find out this one, how much? 37 degree plus angle PSQ, it means Y is equal to 180 degree, right? So add this one, we got 127 degree plus Y is equal to 180 degree. So 127 comes in RHS side, it become a minus, right? So Y is equal to 180 minus 127 degree. Then Y is equal to, make this minus, 53 degree. So here 53. The next problem, sixth one. In a given figure, the side QR of a triangle PQR, the QR side produced up to S, it is extended up to S, and if the bisector of angle PQR and angle PRS, PQR and PRS meet at the point T, so these two bisector at meet at the point T, then prove that the angle QTR QTR is half of the angle QPR. So we want to find out this angle is equal to half of QPR. So here the QT and RT are the bisector. It means these two angles are equal to each other. These two angles are equal to each other. These two angles are equal to each other. So let me solve here. In a triangle TQR, which one? TQR. In this triangle, angle TRS is exterior angle, right? Exterior angle. It is QS. It is exterior angle. And we know that the sum of interior opposite interior angle is equal to exterior angle, right? So it means the angle QTR, this angle plus this angle is equal to exterior angle. QTR plus angle TQR is equal to exterior angle, angle TRS. So angle QTR as it is, this is equal to angle TRS, it comes in RHS side, it become a minus angle TQR. Call this equation 1. And similarly, in a triangle PQR, so angle QRS is a exterior and angle PRS is exterior. Angles. So now the sum of interior angle is equal to exterior angle. So that is the angle PQR plus angle QPR is equal to exterior angle PRS, right? So now the angle PQR, we can write the angle two angle of QTR, because these two are equal. So here QT is a bisector, so I will write here 2 of angle TQR, right? So instead of PQR we can write 2 angle of TQR and plus angle QPR as it is. So this is equal to here also. The angle PRS, we can write the 2 angle of TRS, because these two are the equal. So this whole angle, we can write 2 angle of equal. So 2 angle of TRS, right? So now the 2 angle of TQR comes in RHS side, it becomes a minus, right? So this side remaining angle QPR, the angle QPR is equal to 2 angle of TRS as it is minus, it comes in RHS side, it becomes a minus, the 2 angle of TQR, and take 2 common on both sides. So remaining angle TRS minus angle TQR, right? So here 2 as it is. See here by equation 1, TRS minus QTR is equal to, we can write QTR. So angle QTR from equation 1, right? So this is equal to here QPR as it is. So now 2 comes in RHS side, it become a divide. So this side remaining only QTR is equal to 2 comes this side, 1 by 2 angle QPR as it is. So hence proved. Is it clear? So So here reason you have to write which one bisector QT and RT are bisector.
This is all about this exercise.